When you were younger, did you have an imaginary friend? Welcome back to another review. I will be doing If Imaginary Friend. It was released on the 17th of May, directed and written by John Krasinski, who wrote and directed A Quiet Place films. After losing her mother to cancer a few years ago and her father hospitalized awaiting heart surgery, 12-year-old Bea Kaylee Fleming moves into her grandmother Margaret Fiona Shaw's apartment. She starts to see unfamiliar creatures, ifs who have been left behind as their real life children have grown up. With Cal, Ryan Reynolds, she helps place the ifs with their owners to prevent them from disappearing. The grown-ups never got over the ifs. They were sort of forced to get over them and leave them in the imagination, even though in this movie they seem to need them to get through life. The standout ifs she meets along the way are Blossom, Phoebe Waller-Bridge, and Lou, Steve Carell, who is the big furry purple thing. He was just acting like he does in Despicable Me. I don't know if he acts like that all the time. Is that his go-to acting method? They have a very decorated cast. Louis Gossett Jr., elderly teddy bear. Joaquin Bubble, Emily Blunt, Unicorn, George Clooney, Spaceman, Bradley Cooper, Ice, Matt Damon, Flower, Will Harder, Banana, Richard Jerkins, the art teacher, Keegan-Michael Key, Slime, John Krasinski, Marshmallow, Blake Lively, Octopus, Allison Seager, Viola, Sebastian Maniscalco, Magician Mouse, Christopher Meloni, Cosmo, Matthew Rice, Ghost, Sam Rockwell, Guardian Dog, Maya Rudolph, Alligator, Amy Schumer, Gummy Bear, John Stewart, the robot, Brad Pitt as Keith, who is the invisible if, which I found very unnecessary. He could have just used background acting or less known actors to fill those roles. Even though John Krasinski said that when he wrote the script, he had envisioned which actors he wanted to play the ifs, and he got all of them to play the if, which, to be honest, fair enough, but I just think it's really unnecessary, especially Brad Pitt's character. He was credited for being an invisible character. He didn't say anything. Why? I don't get it. What I did like about the movie was obviously the animation. I love animation. The cinematography, the story, it was okay. You know, a girl's journey to, you know, help the ifs and also relieve her imagination and also just be a kid again, because she had to grow up. Her mother died of cancer. Her father is having heart surgery. She was sort of forced to be an adult. So yeah, the story, I think, was okay. Speaking of reliving imaginations, I don't know if I ever had an imaginary friend, but if I did, if I had to invent an imaginary friend, the person has probably have to tell me like the future, I guess, or give me ideas of what to come up with next in terms of business and stuff like that. I think this movie is good for kids. Obviously, they're still young and innocent. They have imaginary friends. I think it'd be good for them to see this in cinema. I think they would enjoy it. For me, would I watch it again? Absolutely not. I see the idea, I see the vision, but I think John has much better scripts. I think he did have times where it was hilarious. Obviously, his cast, he has Steve, he has Ryan and Awkwafini, who are hilarious, but it doesn't do it for me. Thank you for watching. These are my comments, thoughts, and opinions. You don't have to agree. Until next time, see you in the next video.